kids, welcome to new class, the fifth class. Okay, now today we were going to start our online study of a new book, which is the English Channel from Britannica Learning. You have one more book of grammar, which is called Grammarite. Okay, so today we will get started with the first chapter of it, in which that is a man who found the windmills. Okay. But before that, I have a few questions for you. Just answer, yes or no. Are you the one who loves old stories? Does your heart beat faster when you heard the stories of fairies and warriors and knights and dragons and ogres and sorcerers? Then beware. These tales can drive you mad. It happens to a Spanish gentleman who lives 4 centuries ago in Spain, in a little province of La Mancha. But before that, we should start with the story. It would be good to know about the characters in the story. So in this story, we learn that how can stories of past influence our present imagination. Okay, so let's get started. It's your first chapter, The Man Who Found Windmills, and the characters. There are 2 main characters and one more is there. The first one is Don Quixote. Look at the pronunciation. It is Don Quixote, a Spanish ingenious gentleman who had infatuation for the books, leads him to imagine himself as a knight, as a warrior. Okay. And the second one is Rocinante. Rocinante is his make. It means his old horse. Okay. And the second character, which is the most important one again, Sancho Panza, act as a squire. Actually, is a peasant with a promise that one day get an island to rule. Okay. Before we get started, it would be good to know about some terms that you find new in that book. First word is knight, second is squire. Now, what is a knight? Do you hear about warriors, brave men, courageous men? Okay, just look at this. I have drawn it for you. This is a knight. Okay, it is the K silent one over here. What are these? Some of the words I either found are related to that, I have written on that. Okay, it's a knight. It's the helmet he wears for all these things. He wears for the protection in the war. It is the armor, which is for security, which is for protection. It is knight's shield, and that's its spear, sword. Okay, these are the words related to the knight's chivalry. It means its courage, heroism. He had won many wars, a true gentleman, and most important thing, how many conquests he had made. That's why he get the title of a knight. And he has also an assistant, which is a squire. The knight who is the warrior in the ancient medieval ages. And he is assisted by a squire. Okay. He is also a knight, but a number of battles has less. And a squire get the title of a knight when he became of 21 years. Now, some more things about knight. Knight is a man given a rank of honor by British king because of his special achievements. He was trained to fight as a soldier. Knight in a black armor is assisted by a squire, and kids are like the character. So I searched so much and designed an animated video, animated story for you for that. So, have a look.
The name of which I don't desire to recall, Alonso Quijano, most commonly known as Don Quixote. He loved books so much that he spent entire hours in reading them. Without a doubt, his favorite stories were about the great knights in old Spain, as Don Quixote read through these novels about great deeds of chivalry and accomplishment. He started confusing fantasy with reality in a like manner. He strived to imitate the heroes in the stories, becoming a knight errant. He said, "The world needs brave men like me to fight for justice against evil. From now onwards, I'll go down in the history as Don Quixote de la Mancha. Don Quixote had made all the necessary arrangements to becoming a knight. Those were in this book, in his books. He went up to the attic and found an armor. He laid his hands on an old spear and dented shield, which he had to fix. I almost forget. I will also need a horse. He went down to the stables and there found Rosimante and an old skinny neck. Just then his neighbor Sancho, a kind chubby peasant, was passing by. Don Quixote remembered right away that he also needed a companion in his wanderings. Dear Sancho, every knight needs a faithful squire and an adventurous companion. I can't promise you the world, but if we win fortunate and glory, I'll grant you the privilege of becoming the governor of an island. Sancho was slightly a naive, and so he believed him and accepted the proposal, and this was how such a typical peer set. Seeking adventures, their neighbors couldn't believe their eyes. But what were these lantics up to? They laughed at them for hours but couldn't stop them. Don Quixote, Sancho and Rosimante were strolling along in the plains of La Mancha when they saw some windmills of some great distance. "Son, show me, my friend. Do you see those enormous giants? I shall do battle with them and to the deed stop their evil deeds." "Which giants, my lord? Those over these there in the distance? Aren't at least 30 of them. Can't you see how huge their arms are?" "Those aren't giants, Don Quixote. They are windmills, and those that look like arms to you aren't arms. They are the blades that spin around with the wind." "Sancho, fear doesn't let you see clearly aside. I'll battle them. Don't run away, creatures." Sancho's warning didn't do any good. The blades pushed Don Quixote off his boat. Himself and Rosimante fell on the ground, badly injured. "I told, my lord, I told. They weren't giants, they were windmills. But you didn't listen." "Hush, Sancho. It's magician Frestune's fault, who changed the giants into windmills to deprive me of victory. But I won't give up. The power of my sword is greater than the magician's evil doing." Sancho Panza helped his lord, but he treated his wounds, and they both set off once again in the search of more adventure. The end. So, kids, never miss the fantasy with reality. So now what you have to do, just go through these pages, comprehend them, find out the answers and write the answers in your previous grammar notebook. Take care and be safe.